With this, now we move ahead with another subject in final year MBBS. Now, with the two huge subjects, medicine and surgery, bombarding a medical student. Now, reading gynae and obstetrics during final prof as well as during preparations. I don't know, like, how to go about it and how does one find time to do it and how do we manage it. And gynae and obs being two separate subjects being clubbed into one. So I would like to ask Zainab how to go about it for preparing for entrance exams.
I think gynae-obs is completely selective approach. Only do selective study for gynae-obs. I think all of us here agree, none of us have done gynae-obs thoroughly because you don't find the time to do gynae-obs after doing all these subjects. Okay, so do a very selective approach. I'll just tell you what the important topics are for both gynae and obs. For gynecology, most important is gynae-onc. Okay, you need to do CA cervix, CA endometrium, CA ovary. All the stages you need to know. This is something which you have to revise on the last day because you forget if you do it a long time ago. So this is something you have to revise. And the treatment, stage-wise treatment you need to know. And the way you do the staging has to be very systematic. I mean, the way you will have to study is not just cram up the cancer staging of one, say, CA cervix. What you can do is, you compare, see if there's pelvic node involvement, what will be the stage for say CA cervix, CA endometrium, CA ovary. If there's inguinal node involvement, what will be the stage for all the cancers. That is how you have to study, that is how you'll remember. Because in that, when you're in the exam pressure, it's very difficult to recall, okay, what was the stage 3C in endometrium. So it's very difficult. So if you've done a thorough preparation, then only you'll be able to remember. So that is there, that's the most important thing. Prognostic factors again are very important for gynae cancers also. Then the central part of gynae is PCOS. PCOS, there'll always be one question in All India on PCOS. There was one question in NIMHANS also in PCOS this time. So this is something that you'll have to deal very conceptually. You need to know the pathophysiology of PCOS and how you'll treat every aspect of it. So PCOS is important, the lab findings are very important. Next thing is primary amenorrhea. The approach to primary amenorrhea, delayed puberty, very, very important. AIS, Turner syndrome, Müllerian agenesis, all these things, how to distinguish between all of them, how you'll approach them, looking at a case scenario is very, very important. That is one approach you cannot miss. So I think if you do these three things for gynae, I think it's enough for MCQ exams. Any one or two questions will come from any other topic, will not be that scoring if you, I mean, focus exactly on some other important subject. For obstetrics, I think the most important thing is PIH. Always one or two questions come on PIH. The definition has changed in 2013, so people need to know the new guidelines for PIH and the definition of preeclampsia and how it has changed. The drugs, the ones which are safe in pregnancy, ones not safe in pregnancy, not just antihypertensives, all the drugs mostly which are contraindicated, that is one list you need to memorize, the drugs contraindicated in pregnancy, because a lot of questions have been coming upon the categories. So it's not humanly possible to do all the categories and the drugs belonging to them, but you definitely need to know the category X drugs, the ones which cannot be given. So whenever you look at a question, almost two options will be category X. So you can rule them out and then maybe decide between the two, take a better guess. Mm-hmm. So I think that is how you have to do those questions. Then GDM, there was a question on criteria of GDM which just got changed last year. So they are also focusing on the current trends now. So just keep a track of whatever changes are happening in obstetrics. Apart from that, I think operative obstetrics is very important. Forceps versus ventus, when to prefer which is very important. Caesarean section, vaginal birth after caesarean is a very, very important topic. When it's indicated, when it's contraindicated. Every year there used to be one question from that topic. So that is important. Then reproductive physiology. This is one topic which is important for all India. There have been a lot of questions from reproductive physiology there, when the cardiac output peaks, when the TPR peaks. So that is something you need to focus for all India. Then three topics. HMOL, ectopic pregnancy and abortions. This you have to deal as a whole. How you'll approach, if a patient comes, what will be the protocol? That three tables, there's a book, Dr. J.V. Sharma's book for obstetrics. He's given wonderful tables for all these. So just go through the approach. If a patient comes with ruptured ectopic, what you'll do? If a patient comes with unruptured ectopic, what you'll do? For abortions, recurrent abortions, what are the investigations you'll do? What might be the probable diagnosis? APLA, these are the important topics for OBS. So I think gynae-obs is very, very selective, just do these many topics. I think your PG entrance shouldn't be a problem.
So that was a very wholesome review of the two big subjects condensed in a manner that any one of us can easily, you know, go through it and justifying giving time to medicine, surgery as well as the other subjects also. Amit, would you like to add something to it?
Yeah, the selective approach that Zainab has said is totally justified, especially in ops gyne. Even during our profs, I think we used to do this much only. So yeah, it's a good thing only, selective approach.
Exactly. So this is how we deal with the vast subjects of medicine, surgery and gyne ops, and we go through our entrance exams, I think. Thank you.